Hello friends, welcome to Share Market Friend again. Today I am going to talk about ZEE media group issue that is floating in the market, and a lot of information flow is there about it. Recently I will show you share price of ZEE, okay, ZEE Entertainment Limited. If you see, here was a sudden fall in the share price of ZEE group. ZEE Entertainment Limited, it was around 30%, it touched around 300 rupees. It was, if you check it, our share price, it touched nearly 2015 share price in a single day. Around 1% of equity was sold in a single day. Then its group company Dish also experienced the same stiff fall in a single day. And then SL Propack Limited, which is also group company, okay. These are the few big companies listed on the NSE or BSE. Okay, they also faced such fall. So what was the cause of all this fall, and what are the learnings from this issue, and what is the root cause of all this issue? We'll try to find out. Okay, so first of all, I will try to start it from here. Okay, the first news that came on Friday, it was from the Wire News Network. Okay, it was all about that. They said there were linkages between alleged linkages between ZEE promoters and the Nitank Infra. Actually, this case was all about 3000 crore money deposition in demonetization time. So that was kind of illegal or related illegal activities. So SFIO special financial economic wing, kind of they were researching or inquiring into this. So people started to think that ZEE promoters had link with this company. So share started to fall on that news or related. Anyways, share was trading, it was on its lower side, so it started to fall on this kind of news. But there was a lot of flow of around 1% of equity into the market. So apart from this news flow, who was that person or who was that entity that was selling such a huge amount of shares of such a reputed firm, which is a part of Nifty also? So I'd like to tell you that this shares came from a NBFC or other mutual fund kind of entities, where ZEE group has pledged there around a lot of shares. Okay, so what was the reason that NBFCs or whatever the entity started to sell those pledged shares? Okay, for that I will tell you some kind of logic that I understood from all this matter. Okay, whenever a company pledges their 100 number of shares, so for their valuation, that company receives around 80 rupees, or for 100 rupees, 100 shares suppose, so it receives after haircut around 80 to 50 rupees. So if this company share starts to fall in value and its market value become 80, then to maintain that ratio, they to maintain or to recover that money or to maintain that ratio, they start to sell those shares whatever they have. So due to fall in the shares, so many other financial institutions, that is what I understood from this all matters, they started to sell their pledged shares. So a lot of share flow came into the market, dragging the share to multi-year low. So what was the reason that ZEE group had pledged their shares to these companies? So after this news of Wire News, open letter from Subhash Chandra came into the press. That was all about, he stating that how he was struggling to deliver interest on loan he has taken for various purposes. So he had around 60% of major shares in the 7 companies of ZEE group, out of which 30% shares were pledged. So that money was used for various road projects, solar projects, infra projects, that he explained in that letter. Also, he told in that letter that so many investments into this what you call projects, solar projects or infra companies like SL Multi Ventures, etc., that gone bad, though they're not declared as NPA or something. Also, he was trying to state that it was his good faith or positive business strategy that he didn't choose to declare them NPA, etc., and instead he tried to deliver those interest payments through pledging of his shares and through using his personal funds, etc. So that is what he tried to explain. So this was all about badly gone infra projects which are executed by Z Group, whatever you call it, promoters, etc., Subhash Chandra and all people. Also, he mentioned about negative result he got from Desh buyout from other group that he referred to his brother. Okay, that's all he mentioned in that letter. So he had pledged 30% shares, out of which a lot of shares came into the market. So this was all the cause of this whole issue. What is the next thing then that is going to happen? Okay, so that could happen. That it is that if there is a further selling in the share, though yesterday on Monday that share ended up positively, it recovered from the fall up to half of it. So it went down around 30%, etc., but it recovered to 15%. So if it goes further down due to some reasons or due to negative results, though their results are positive, they are positive on their ZeeFi projects also, DeFi business line or stream also. But if suppose it goes down, then lot of pledged shares can come into the market and they can create liquidity into market that can further downsize or pull down the share price. Second challenge is that there could be a rating downgrade if it is there due to their pledged share percentage or their investment related to those pledged share percentage and inability to service that loan interest, etc. So that could in a difficult case can downgrade the share also. Also, there is a systemic risk related to Z Group bonds issued by their infra companies. Also, for the mutual funds who hold Z Group company shares, so negative thing for them. Okay, recently there is one more development that recently in that letter also Mr. Subhash Chandra mentioned that he had meeting with so many suitors who are going to lend, who are going to buy stake in Z, that he is going to half of stake he is going to divest to other strategic investor. Also about lenders, he had meeting with them. They given him 3 months of time, so it will be a time to watch what happens in these 3 months. If Z could sell its stake to other investor that can give it money. There is a positive news also that Jio, Alibaba, etc. are interested in buying that Z stake. If there is such a competition, then that could bring out a better price for Z. So in turn, helping overall to the Z. So that will be the time. That will be time to watch out in the future. Okay. So in this 3 months they are going to decide that what happens to this bonds issued by their infra companies to the that share, especially bonds are holded by so many mutual funds like Aditya Birla, HDFC, ICICI, etc. So it is a great systemic risk that what I am sensing here. Okay, so also there were issues that what is the link of Island FS with this Z overall issue. So what I learned is that also in their open letter, Subhash Chandra mentioned that they were rolling their debt repayment or their bonds in the bond market through pledging of shares, through using their individual fund, etc. But it became difficult to roll their bond related to infra projects where they are not yet defaulted on the interest payment. So it became difficult to roll over those bonds because of the Island FS issue. Due to the Island FS, there was separate episode on Island FS. It's a big story altogether. Okay, so due to the Island FS issue, there was a tightening in the liquidity market due to which bond market freeze mostly in last to last month. So due to which it became difficult to roll over their bonds. So because of that negative sentiment aggravated about bond rolling over and they're using individual fund, etc. So that created more negative news for the people to whom they have pledged their shares, in turn generating more shares to sell in the market. Okay, so this was all about Z's issue. Okay, also few things we can learn from this issue, that if you are having your own business in future, if whoever is listening this episode, if he's going to register his company in the stock market and he has a good reputable company, then we get a learning or we get a new point here who don't know about it, that they can lend their, they can borrow money on pledging their shares. So if you have a good company who has a reputed structure in the market, then you can use your money for borrowing money from the NBFCs, etc., where which you can use for different infra kind of road projects. So this is kind of business pattern that rich people in India or big conglomerates in India use. That is what we learn from all this issue. Also, the how to handle such kind of issue, we are learning it from Subhash Chandra right now. Okay, hope for the positive that it's coming up positive. Now it's a Nifty 50 company, so it is definitely, it has a strong fundamentals. Anyhow, Zee has various network of entertainment plus other SL Pro Pack like companies. Also the Z5 pattern, Z5 platform is also improving. It is around 2nd to third number in India on entertainment subscribed or internet entertainment platforms. Okay, so this was all about Z Group and all that related issue, and I shared my understanding with you. I hope you liked it. If you don't like, you can click on dislike also. Okay, if you want to watch other videos of my channel, you can check into, click on my share market friend name, channel name, and click on the videos. There you can get so many videos. If you want, you can click on the share and you can share it with your friends, Facebook, WhatsApp, etc. Okay, thank you for listening to me. Thank you for subscribing my channel. Thank you.